Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss population growth models. We're going to be looking at a specific differential equation that models population growth. It's called the logistic differential equation. It says that dp/dt is equal to kp times 1 minus p over m, where p here is the population at a particular point in time, and m is called the carrying capacity, so the population can never exceed the carrying capacity. So this differential equation has a solution, which I've written here in blue. It's p of t equals m, all divided by 1 plus a times e to the negative kt, where a is equal to m minus p naught all over p naught. P naught, by the way, is the initial population at t equals 0. Let's go ahead and do an example right away using these formulas. Here is our example, and we're going to assume the logistic model in this particular population growth scenario. The initial population is 2,000 with a carrying capacity of 20,000. If the population grows to 5,000 after 1 year, what will it be after another 4 years? Let's go ahead and carefully work through this solution. So we'll start by writing down what we're given. We're told that the initial population is 2,000. That's going to be our p naught or p sub 0. That's equal to 2,000. We're also told that the carrying capacity is 20,000. That's our capital M. So capital M is equal to 20,000. And we're assuming the logistic model, and we want to know, if the population grows to 5,000 after 1 year, what will it be after another 4 years? So basically, we have to use the function P of T here in blue, which gives us the population at a particular point in time. So we have M, we just need A. So A is m minus p naught over p naught. So let's work that out. A is m, so m is 20,000, minus p naught, which is 2,000. And it's all being divided by 2,000. So this is 18,000 over 2,000, which is the wonderful number of 9. So we have that A is equal to 9. So now we have A, we have M, we can plug it all into P of T, and we'll have almost everything we need, but not quite. So plugging everything into P, we have P of T is equal to, well, let's see, M was 20,000 over, and then on the bottom we have 1 plus A, A is 9, and then we have E to the negative KT. The problem is we don't have a complete picture for our function because we're missing K. So to find k, what we're going to use is the next sentence, or at least the first part of the next sentence. It says here the population grows to 5,000 after 1 year. Okay, so we're going to use that to find k. Basically, if we plug in 1, this whole thing should be equal to 5,000. So let's do that. So this means that p of 1, which is going to be 20,000, over 1 plus 9, e to the negative k, right? Because t is 1, this should be equal to 5,000. We're going to solve this for k. To do that, we're basically going to multiply both sides by 1 plus 9 e to the negative k. So I'll write it again down here and come to the middle of the screen here. We have 20,000 over 1 plus 9 e to the negative k, and that's equal to 5,000, just writing it again. Now we're going to clear the fractions, so we're going to multiply by 1 plus 9 e to the negative k. We're doing that because we're looking for k, and it's in the denominator, and it's being, in the exponent of the e. It's not a good place. So this should help. It's a good first step. So then we have 20,000 equal to 5,000, which are some big numbers. Parentheses 1 plus 9 e to the negative k. Let's get rid of this 5,000 by dividing by it. So divide by 5,000. Divide by 5,000. That gives us 4 equal to 1 plus 9 e to the negative k. And then we can just keep solving here. So basically we want to isolate e to the negative k. Subtract 1, we'll get 3 equals 9. E to the negative k, then divide by 9, That implies that we have 1/3 equals e to the negative k. And we can take the natural log of both sides. So we get ln of 1/3 equals ln of e to the negative k. And this is a key step. You know, whenever you're trying to get rid of an e and there's a problem like this, you want to take the natural log because there's a formula that says if you have the natural log of e to the x, that's equal to x. So in this particular case, our x is just negative k. So this is ln 1/3 equals negative k. So finally, k is equal to negative ln 1/3. That's not the answer, but it's important. I'm going to put it in a circle. So recall that we had p of t equal to, and it was 20,000 over 1 plus 9. And it was 9e to the negative kt. That's what we had on the bottom, okay? So this is already negative, so the negative and the negative are going to cancel. So it's going to be e to the ln 1/3 t. Now we finally have a formula that gives us the population after t years. So now we can finally answer the question. Let's go read it again. The question said, if the population grows to 5,000 after 1 year, we use that to find k, what will it be after another 4 years? So after another 4 years, it's going to be P of 5. So P of 5 is equal to 20,000 over 1 plus 9 E, the natural log of 1/3, and then times 5. And if you put this in your calculator, you get approximately 19,285.71429. So at this point, you would want to round. You're not quite at 19,286 people, so I'm just going to say 19,285. You could round up if you wanted to. I'm going to round down because we're not really at a full person yet. A little bit more time and we'd be at, you know, 19,286. So either answer would probably be fine, a 5 or a 6. But pretty interesting problem because, you know, we used the solution to the equation. We didn't have to actually go through and like solve the differential equation. That would take more work. But hopefully after watching this video, you feel more comfortable with using these formulas, the formulas for P and A, and how to apply them to a problem. I hope it's been helpful. And if you feel like you learned some math, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.